Welcome to this heartwarming story about Catherine, Princess of Wales, a tale of bravery, generosity, and unwavering spirit. Recently, Catherine, the beloved Princess of Wales, shared some deeply personal news that has moved millions around the world. At the age of 42, she has been diagnosed with cancer, a revelation that she bravely shared through an emotional video on her official Instagram account. In this video, which has been viewed nearly 100 million times, Catherine expressed her profound gratitude for the outpouring of support and encouragement she has received from people globally. She also requested privacy for herself and her family as they navigate this challenging time, emphasizing the importance of focusing on her recovery. As the world holds its breath and sends its best wishes for Catherine's full recovery, it is heartening to reflect on her own contributions to those battling cancer. One particularly touching gesture stands out: her decision to donate several inches of her own hair to the Little Princess Trust. This charitable organization provides free, real human hair wigs to children and young people who have lost their hair due to illness. The decision to donate her hair came during a routine haircut at Kensington Palace. Catherine's hairstylist, Joey Wheeler, was the one who cut her locks, which were then sent to the organization under a different name to keep the donation anonymous. The hair was shipped under a pseudonym to ensure that the recipients would not know it came from a member of the royal family, believing instead that it was from a generous woman living in Kensington. This act of kindness from the princess brought immense joy to the Little Princess Trust. Helen Creese, a spokesperson for the charity, expressed their delight upon learning about the donation. She said, "Not only are we thrilled that she has given us her hair, but we are also extremely grateful. It's a beautiful act of kindness, and it's something we see from many people who wish to help those suffering from illness." The organization receives many anonymous donations, and while the true identity of the donor is often unknown, the impact of such generosity is always profound. In her poignant video, Catherine connected with others who are facing similar battles. She revealed that the cancer was discovered following an abdominal surgery she underwent in January. Despite the surgery being successful, further tests revealed the presence of cancer. As a result, her medical team recommended she start a course of prophylactic chemotherapy, which she is currently undergoing. Catherine's message was one of hope and solidarity, urging those affected by cancer not to lose faith. "You are not alone," she said, offering a beacon of hope to many who are struggling with the disease. Hair loss is a common side effect of cancer treatments like chemotherapy and radiation. While not all cancer patients lose their hair, a significant number do. Chemotherapy targets rapidly growing cancer cells but also affects other fast-growing cells in the body, including hair follicles. This can lead to hair loss, not just on the scalp but also in other areas of the body. Radiation therapy, on the other hand, causes hair loss only in the area being treated. The National Health Service reports that hair usually starts to grow back once treatment ends. For many patients, wearing scarves, hats, or wigs helps them cope with the emotional and psychological challenges of hair loss, which is why organizations like the Little Princess Trust are so important. Catherine's message resonated deeply with many, including a two-time cancer survivor named Christina. Christina, who underwent prophylactic chemotherapy herself, shared words of encouragement for the princess. She empathized with Catherine's struggle, particularly the difficulty of explaining her illness to her children, Charlotte, who is 8, Louis, who is 5, and George, who is 10. Christina emphasized the importance of maintaining a positive attitude for the sake of her children, recalling how her own family, especially her husband Mark and her eldest son David, had been her pillars of strength during her treatment. Despite her fears and the challenges she faced, Christina found strength in her family and her work at the Clatterbridge Cancer Clinic, where she received treatment. Michelle Mitchell, the Chief Executive Officer of Cancer Research UK, highlighted the impact of Catherine's announcement on public awareness. She noted a significant increase in visitors to their cancer information web pages following the princess's announcement. "We are extremely grateful for the overwhelming response," Mitchell said. She emphasized the importance of early detection and urged anyone noticing unusual changes in their body to consult their primary care physician, as early diagnosis can significantly improve treatment outcomes. As we reflect on Catherine's courage and generosity, it's a reminder of the power of kindness and the strength of the human spirit. Her story is not just about a battle against cancer, it's about resilience, empathy, and the incredible impact of giving. While the world watches and waits for updates on her health, Catherine's example continues to inspire and uplift, offering hope to all who are facing similar challenges. In the face of her illness, Catherine remains a beacon of grace and strength, embodying the true spirit of a royal. Her story is a testament to the power of compassion and the importance of supporting one another through life's toughest battles.